Welcome to John Lewis 3D Learning. In this presentation, we are going to learn water chapter in 9th standard chemistry. The topic is universal solvent. See, as usual, let us begin with the question. Why is it difficult to find pure water in nature? Because water is a remarkable solvent. Solvent means what? It can dissolve any other substance. So first of all, water is a remarkable solvent. Remarkable solvent. That means what? It can dissolve many substances. So water can dissolve many substances. So the substances may be in solid or liquid or gas. So the substances may be solid, not just solid, it can dissolve another liquid substance also, or anything in gaseous form also. See, all these three nature of the substances can be dissolved in water. That is why it is very difficult to find pure water in nature. It can very easily dissolve anything which comes in contact. Okay, let's begin with another question here. Water is also known as universal solvent. Why? So the reason is same, because water can dissolve many substances. This is also known as universal solvent. So what is solvent in the very first place? We should understand what is meant by solvent, what is meant by solute, and what is meant by solution. Only then you can understand what is meant by universal solvent. So what is solute? The substance that dissolves. For example, if you take common salt we use at home and you put it in water, that dissolves, isn't it? So that is what the sodium chloride salt is known as solute, the substance that dissolves. The substance that dissolves is called solute. Then what is solvent? The substance in which the solute dissolves. The substance in which the solute dissolves. See, already we know what is solute. The substance which dissolves is solute. In which substance that dissolves, that is known as solvent. In which the solute dissolves is known as solvent. Okay, is it clear? Then what is meant by solution? So the mixture of these two. But the mixture should be uniform. See, for example, you take water in a container and you put ordinary common salt which we are using at home, and sodium chloride dissolves. Therefore, sodium chloride is solute. Sodium chloride is solute. In which that sodium chloride dissolves? In water. Therefore, water is a solvent. Water is a solvent. Then what is solution? It is a mixture of solute and solvent. But that should be homogeneous. Homogeneous means what? Uniform. See, after the sodium chloride dissolves in water, so the concentration of sodium chloride should be uniform everywhere. That would have spreaded equally all over water. That is what is known as homogeneous. Therefore, what is solution? It is a homogeneous mixture of. Homogeneous means the concentration is same everywhere. So, homogeneous mixture of solute and solvent. Solute and solvent is known as solution. Is it clear? So now, why water is a universal solvent? Because not only sodium chloride, many other substances dissolve. Even many other liquid also dissolves. Many gases also dissolves. For example, carbon dioxide, oxygen, these are all gases. They also dissolve in water. Then why does etching occur inside sealed glass bottles containing distilled water? Okay, water. So glass cannot dissolve in water, that we know. Suppose water is stored in a closed container or in a closed glass bottle. Suppose water is there. If it is a glass, it is made up of glass. Okay, you can see for a long period, maybe for 3 months, 6 months, then you can see there are some etching on the sides of the glass. That etching means what? That the glasses would have been corroded. But we learnt glasses, they do not dissolve in water. Then how this etching happens, how this corrosion takes place? Even though the glasses are apparently insoluble in water, but when water is stored for a long period in a closed glass bottle, and you can see some etching has taken place because a trace of glasses might have been dissolved in water over the long period. That is why the etching of the sealed glass bottles containing distilled water appear. Is it clear? Even though it is apparently insoluble, if you store them for a longer period, there may be a trace of glass getting dissolved in water. That is why that etching appears inside the glass bottles. Clear? Okay. What is importance of dissolved salts in water? So there are so many salts water can dissolve, isn't it? So what is the importance of dissolved salts in water? So you take plants, so plants needs minerals and salts, no, for its growth. So dissolved water, sorry, the dissolved salts in water are what? It may be salts or it may be minerals or it may be some impurities, but plants need salts and minerals for its growth. Therefore, the salts dissolved in water is very, very important for plants. What is the second one? Human bodies. So human bodies also need various minerals, no, for its growth. So that is why the dissolved salts are very important in water. And third one, taste. So if you drink so collect water from the natural sources, and if you drink, it will have a specific taste. It may be salty or it may be sweet. It all depends on what? The kinds of salts or the minerals dissolved in it. So once we boil the water becomes tasteless, no? Why? Because the dissolved gases are evaporated or the dissolved salts are filtered off, then water loses its taste. So pure water is tasteless. So the taste of water depends on the salts and minerals dissolved in it. That is why the dissolved salts are very, very important in water. Clear? So it is used for plants, it is used for it's very valuable for human bodies, and it also gives taste to water. Hope you understood why water is called universal solvent and why it is very tough to get pure water and what are the importance of dissolved salts in water. So thank you very much for watching. If you like it, please click the like button and share it with your friends. Until we meet next time, bye bye.